Well, you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Second down and a little more than a yard here. They'll stay on the ground with Williams. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and two.
Well, I would have figured after the 9-yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was, and now it's third down.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have the Broncos' first down, and it's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and two. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now a give up the middle to Williams. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. Here's Wilson. Screenplay set up for Williams. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. Call it a pickup of three, and also now likely a punt on their opening drive. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. Jones and the Pats now with a first and 10 at their own 46. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Now a short one to Gesicki, and he goes out of bounds and looks like right at the 50. Second and six. They'll run it. This is Ramondre Stevenson. And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. Throwing Jones. And this one is going to be off the mark. Too far out in front. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Second and 10. Now Jones. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Straight ahead, it's Stevenson. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. They go play action here on first down. A throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
Offense is moving a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they're on a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. To throw on second and 10. Jones over the middle here to Brown. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for the first with Stevenson. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone.
40 yards rushing for him on their opening drive of the contest, and it's now 1st and goal.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance, but a short yardage trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
From the 2, here's 1st and goal. Looking to throw, Jones. Quick throw, but incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Stevenson. Is into the end zone. Touchdown, New England. Chad Ryland now to add the PAT. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots.
Makes the score Patriots 7, Broncos nothing.
Chad Ryland. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And he's able to get up here to the 26.
Good position to be in here, 2nd and inches.
Again, it's Williams. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here.
3rd and 2, now Wilson. And this is going to be intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased.
There's Henry. Touchdown, Patriots. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Patriots are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second, then you got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
Ryland on for the extra point.
And it's good to make it 14-0.
Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four.
Go, go, go.
They run it again with Williams. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 44 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Second and 10, it's Wilson again. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Dietrich Wise running through and dropping him for the sack. Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation, because with that type of a lead, they feel like they can take a few more chances and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game.
On third down, Wilson. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And he takes this one back into the end zone. The Patriot defense has a touchdown. Wow, this one, it is getting out of hand early. They add a pick six to the ledger now. 3-score lead still in the first half.
And all that celebrating that you see and hear from those defenders, it's not just because they scored a touchdown on a pick six. It's because they're pitching a shutout in this one. Every defender's dream.
Extra point by Rylan, up and good. And that makes the score 21 to zip.
Broncos nothing.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And now the rookie's free. And he'll weave all the way up to just a few yards shy of midfield. A great return.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Trying to get something positive to happen here before the break, and they sure need it. They went for the big one, but it winds up incomplete.
On second down, Wilson. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
And they've been kept off the scoreboard in this first half, but here toward the end, they're trying to change that in one fell swoop, but that winds up incomplete.
14.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And he is going to have a Broncos first down. And they convert in style right there. A big play on fourth and long.
I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. This offense continues to shoot themselves in the foot. Here, another sack.
All game long, we've seen missed assignments, which have led to turnovers, sacks. This group has not played well at all here in the first half.
Wilson's throw caught here by Dulcich.
So
two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
21, Broncos nothing.
So full blitz, we going all out. It don't matter any time of day, I came to ball out. We TCG, never duck a smoke or any call out. Better be ready to go to war until we fall out. 0-60 like Ludacris, we came to roll out. You know I gotta get my checks, so please don't make me hold out. Bust down Cuban in the summer day, I make it cold out. They was hot then, now they cold now. Left wrist dripping, I got it froze now. Went from rags to riches, take the clothes now. My name heavy all across the globe now. We ain't playing HBCU, I strike up the band. Stomping on them like a cute dog or alpha man. In Miami, hard rock jumping like a rock band. You know me, I love my green and tees like a Packers fan. I'm a player, gotta keep it player, how the game go. With the steppers, I ain't gotta tell them, they just train to go. Calling plays and I'm calling shots like the head coach. First class, so we take the private, we don't do coach. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now.
Dirty, yeah, you know we global with it. Black fit, limo tint, you don't know who in it. Whole team having motion, world no winning. I'm known for handling, been in the other dudes known for dissing. Big motion, boy, big vibing, boy. Tell them, pop that loud talk down, cause they ain't making noise. Yeah, homie, we them boys, who they be preaching about. If you see LT around, Reballers bound to make a crowd. Let it try.
Any, many, mighty, mo, I knock them down three in a row. From the street straight to the field, from the field right to the show. All my dogs are trained to go. Make sure my people don't work no more. Been let down so many times and stabbed my back. I swear it don't hurt no more. Got dirt all on my hands, but I still watching and count this money. I had to stop rocking so many chains. I was trying to work out and it hurt my stomach. I get them wrapped, that boy, mommy. Black on black, this Maybach done. When times was dark, we stood on the block around the clock. Now my life, son. I had to make it out. Rest a piece to Dolph. I took that paper out. Wanted some more laying out on the dough and bought my neighbor's house. I done so many favors for some people. Feel like I'm favored out. No eating in, we taking out. Same people who was cheering, they hating now. But so what? Damn Marino seats inside this road. Truck, they Dolphin blue. Big homie, y'all little boys better remember who y'all talking to. It's gonna cost you like a 50 for me and the gang, and we just walking through. We count money often too.
No problems. They don't want no problems. They don't want no problems. They don't want no problems.
check.
Yeah, where the ops, I ain't ducking smoke. Kick it off, no, we tryna scope. Too easy, I'ma run it up with my eyes closed like Pat Mahomes. Red flag him, I send him home. Hail Mary, I send him long. Another touchdown, hit the gritty on him. Gotta pull in their camera phones. H-time, throw the city up, I finna pick the playoffs like a Zay. When it's pressure, can't get out the pocket. Got the cannon on me, I feel like Brady. Chasing after Lombardi, we just barely get started. Catch a play, I'm like Megatron, you don't know nobody that can guard
him. Took a L, but if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell, huh?
They don't want no problems. They don't want no problems. They don't want no problems. They don't want no problems.
All I know is when I ain't never took a L, but if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell.
What's the point of having if you ain't gonna use it? Watch my games and play my music. I'm stuck in the game. I pray on lose. He changed my neck, keep giving me bruises. They don't want these problems, cause we ain't lose. I'm calling the plays, just gotta keep moving. Only option is win, cause we ain't lose. Get a name in this game, you gotta be proof. All I know is loyalty for my team is what I stand on. It's simple, I turn the corner when got a sack and put my man on. Like magic, everything gon' turn to gold, I put my hands on. Just bought another lot next to my crib for me to expand on.
They don't want no problems.
They don't want it.
Don't want no problems.
They don't want
no problems. They don't want no problems.
They don't want it.
Don't want no problems. All I know is when I ain't never took a L. But if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell, huh?
They don't want no problems.
Took a L, but if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell.
It's that groundbreaking. When I pull up, leave the ground shaking. Cause they ain't think I was gon' blow, they be like, how I make it. Talking like they finna stop something, it's go time, let's line it up. I've been ready to mop something the whole time, my stomach growling. I ain't gon' pick up for no 100,000. I need a Billy tryna go and buy the public housing. Yeah, cut that stove on, my name hot like fajita play. I don't need a break. Told my partner, crank that to the meter
like break. Mr. P, who want it? No limit, who run it? Dreadhead, cool runners. GMF, good money. New whip, 200. Soldiers with me, 300. If it ain't about the money, please don't count on me coming. No, they don't want no problems. These problems gon' be problematic. Don't want no smoke or no static. I don't do no dramatics. Them boys faker than plastic. I tell them jump in the bag. Cause I've been in my bag. Speeding off in the chat, yeah.
They don't want no problems.
They don't want
no problems. They don't want no problems.
They don't want
took a L, but if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell, huh?
They don't want no problems.
They don't want no problems.
They don't want no problems.
They don't want no problems. All I know is when I ain't never took a L, but if I take a L, then you know I'm raising hell, huh?
The NFL on EA Sports has come to the Twin Cities at U.S. Bank Stadium in downtown Minneapolis. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one in the NFC, as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Minnesota Vikings. Greg Joseph now ready to get this one started, and we are underway from Minneapolis. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved. The home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. The Florida Atlantic man, Greg Joseph, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 20. Thank you. On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Oh, his first throw of the game, going to be intercepted. Picked off by a Caleb Evans. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy is not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one. And let him know he'll be back the very next series.
Cousins' throw taken in by Hockenson here. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. First carry for the Boise State Bronco, Alexander Madison. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Play fake, Cousins. And that one going to come up short, low throw.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let it just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
On second down, this is Madison. And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
That was a really nice run there to bring up third and short. After the incompletion on first down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
Play action now, Cousins. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. And they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The speed of Jordan Hicks on display there as he gets the tackle for loss. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now Hurts looking to change the play. Looking to throw on second down. Hurts. And that'll be incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Hurts sets up to throw it. That is caught. Now he's free at the 35. He may go. Turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Elliott Good with a PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Jefferson going to go in motion right. He's going to get it on the jet sweep. Oh, he pulls over it. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5. But defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Now Cousins fakes a jet sweep, and off play action, he wants to throw it. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 22 there on the 3rd down conversion.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the 1st down and then some.
Off the play fake, Cousins. His man, there's Jordan Addison, and he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a 1st down again. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. The Vikings with the football here to begin the 2nd quarter as they've got it with a 1st and 10. They'll go Madison up the middle. And room there to work it inside the 25. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. On play action, Cousins. Short throw caught by the tight end Oliver. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on 3rd down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up 3rd down.
On 3rd and 1, here's Cousins. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Vikings 1st down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a 1st down.
And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They work now on 2nd and 9. Now Cousins. He gets it to Addison. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down. To throw, Cousins. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Multiple players combined for their team's 1st sack of the game.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on 1st and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, 1st and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Here's Madison running left. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now. They go play action. Cousins. Touchdown, Vikings. Josh Oliver. A 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Vikings are an extra point away from evening this one up. Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number one. Drive number two leads them right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back, tremendous poise, confidence never lost. And obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and we are tied at seven. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
But first down, Hurts. And he'll get this into the hands of Swift once again. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Hurts. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. 7 yards there and a first down. Here's Hurts to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Here's second and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Towards the end zone for Brown. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep, try and throw some air under it, and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
Completion here as they fail to connect on third.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked by Cameron Bynum. And the Vikings are going to get the ball back on the turnover as they hold on fourth down.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Here's second and four from the 24. Cousins now. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Hassan Reddick able to use that strength to get him for a loss of two. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. The fair catch taken short of the goal line, and they'll begin this third quarter at their own 25. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles, so as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one, and we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Gonna run with Madison again. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is, that's where the linebackers usually play. First level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle. And oftentimes, we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. On the handoff, it's Madison. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they do finally get him at the 12. 83 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. And a guy that can change the game, shows you a glimpse of it right there, taking the ball down inside the red zone.
It just tells you how tough it is for a defense. You just hold on all game and essentially hold your breath. Will they break?
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Zach Cunningham rolling in to get the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Now a give to Madison. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Throwing his Cousins. Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Keely Ringo picks it off. And the Eagles are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second down. Here's Hurts. Now, a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine.
He'll look to throw. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. They will run straight ahead with Swift. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. They did it.
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. They'll drop the throw. Looking here for Smith downfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Here's Powell on the return. It's a net of 40 there, a punt of 48, and a return of 8. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
Out routes are always timing routes, and if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. It looked like he led him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. Cousins now on second down. He's going to find Jefferson open downfield. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
Here's Madison running on first down. Trying to turn the car, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. To throw is Cousins. Justin Jefferson bringing in the slam. And he'll go down, shy of the 40 at the 41. Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career. Because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football.
And I don't think he got there. No, they stopped him right where it all started. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to pick up the Vikings' first down. Boy, that was a tough couple of yards to pick up, but they convert on fourth and one. In lieu of the sneak on fourth and inches, they just say, give it to the big man in the backfield.
Yeah, fullback no less. Not many of those left in the NFL, but for those that have one, perfect time to use them, perfect time to get it done.
Cousins on the throw, let him too much that time. It's incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides, and there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Well, you don't have to beg the Philly faithful to make noise. On their feet for third down. Going on the ground with Madison. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain.
So where all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick in the game forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. Joseph's got it. Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides.
Greg Joseph to kick off for Minnesota.
Joseph now to kick this one away. Boston Scott on the return from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Here's first and 10. To throw. Flush to his right. That is incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
They'll look to throw. Pass complete, Goddard. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Dave's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Here now, third down. They'll try and run here with Swift. There he goes, right side. He may go. DeAndre Swift. Touchdown. DeAndre Swift. 67 yards. And the Eagles use the defensive breakdown to take the lead away here in the fourth. They get one more as the extra points have been good. And the lead is now 14-10. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. And the fair catch taken. No time to come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. They'll come up first and 10 here. Cousins to throw. Pass complete. It's Madison. Not good. They didn't move the football an inch, and precious time ticking off the clock. They'll come up now on second down. Cousins completes this to Jefferson. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's first and 10 now. Now Cousins. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Second down, 8 yards to go. Here's Cousins. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. This pass rush, even that's a long game long, and another example of it right there in the closing moment.
Not only with the pass rush, but how well they coach
into the passing lane and knock it away, as we just saw there.
Back to throw. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout. He'll look to throw. Open man is Osborne. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Now first and goal. He's back to throw. This is Alexander Madison out of the backfield with it. And he's across for a touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
Charles, that drive was perfect, methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side.
No way you could have drawn up a better final drive, because not only did they keep their eyes on the end zone, but they made sure they bled the clock out as well and denied their opponent a chance to respond. That's just terrific situational football to end this one.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25.
This is first and 10.
Hey, Silver.
From the gun, it's Hurts.
And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. This ball intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And the Vikings are going to hang on the final play. They get the turnover to seal this football game.
What a finish in this one, Charles. You know, this group, they come in, they have to fight a hostile atmosphere every snap. They get the late score, they get the victory, and that flight home, it's going to be a little sweeter after this one.
And Brandon, just like you, I was fired up for that last sequence. How about that? Wouldn't you have loved to have been in the huddle when they were mounting that game-winning drive? Big-time moment. No one shied away from it. They tuned out the crowd.